Well, what's going on, ladies and gentlemen? It is Sunday afternoon, and me and Mama Bear are having fun with our good friends, Matt and Lauren Tramco. They called and said they were seeing a bunch of tilapia and cichlids and everything else. So we were like, heck, let's grab the bows, go do some bow fishing. Oh man, a big one right there.
Yeah, buddy. Mama's on her game today.
Mama's on her game. What'd you get?
Cichlid.
That's a
cichlid.
Mayan cichlid. That's
all. Oh yeah. Do you guys see that up there on my camera? You guys see that?
Oh yeah.
I might not be able to shoot a gar, but I can shoot a cichlid.
I shot high again.
I don't know if Rob's shooting any of the mullet. At least I shot the first fish today.
Hey. That's good. I'm happy for you. See them all over there? Right here under us? Well, you guys, I'm scaring them today.
Mama's back in the game.
Did I get him? Dadgummit, I thought I had him.
One, two, three. Oh, we were both behind you.
I was saying just a half step to your left.
See, guys, this is what he does. Sneaks him behind me and then says, hey, honey, move to the left so he can get the prime shooting.
Got him.
Good job. Bob's on the board. Tilapia. Nice one. Ooh, holy crap.
Back up just a hair. Nice. Big old whopper. Look at that, y'all.
Right.
Take and loosen up that barb right there. Turn that backwards. He's ready to go. Is that what it is? A blue tilapia? We'll check with our resource manager here.
We looked it up this morning. It was a blue tilapia.
Really? So what's your favorite thing to do during summer?
Fish or go to Michigan.
Fish or go to Michigan. Now, what would you do in Michigan?
I visit my grandma every summer and I go to Michigan.
Yeah? Oh, right there. Oh, man. I thought I nailed him.
Oh, I was an inch away from that one, I swear to God.
Well, honey, you might as well be 10 feet away from him. If you miss him, you miss him. I mean, close doesn't count in bow fishing. Dadgum! These easy ones they put too much pressure on me.
Honey, the hard ones put too much pressure on you. Look at how many iguanas. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
Got him. Got him. Got him, boys. Ooh. Nice one. Nice one. That's what I'm talking about, y'all. Hey, Sarah may have got a little head start on me. I will say that, but that was me being a gentleman. Okay, there should be a gazillion fish in here. Honey bud,
at least I have it on film that I didn't shoot it.
Neutral. Dadgummit.
Teamwork, baby. You got it?
Nice shot.
Thank you. Tilapia.
That's what we're after right there, baby.
This is a cichlid?
Oh! That was Boone and Crockett-sized tilapia right there, and I let him get away. You guys, that will go down as the one that got away, right there.
My net girl, my net girl, my net girl! Eat him, eat him, eat him! Got it? Where are the numbers now? How come you just are quiet?
Sweetheart, we're tied up now. You've got several
we're
negative...
We're tied? How does that happen?
I got Babe, like you got several points. Negative points, okay? You gotta play by the rules. This isn't like jungle rules here, all right? You wound fish, you're losing points. Oh, just yeah, that I'm simple.
Fine. What the heck is he talking about? Sarah's winning.
Thanks, girl.
Look, Matt, you gotta start, you gotta fix your drive. You're putting her on all the fish here. This
Rob,
is.
I literally just need a tail and shooting.
This is, I mean, I think there's a conspiracy going on here.
Got it. Robert said that the last fish we were gonna be done, but apparently he meant his last fish.
So today has been an absolutely amazing day. We got to spend a lot of time together, and Sarah did actually beat the snot out of me pretty bad, but we had a great time. Now here, I got one question for you. Would you ever want to go bow fishing yourself?
Yeah.
Do you have a bow to go bow fishing with?
Yeah.
Yeah? Do you have a good one?
We have a recurve bow.
Yeah? Well, I tell you what, that bow right there can be adjusted all the way down to you. Would you like it? You can have it.
That's She's like, I don't know if you're being serious or not.
You've got your own, you've got your very own diamond sonar bow fishing bow now. And I've got a couple extra arrows because I know you're gonna lose some arrows, okay?
Are you trying to say she's not good?
I'm not saying she's not good, but hey, everybody loses arrows and I don't want her to run out of gear.
I almost did.
Now.
I almost did, yes I did. My string came off.
It's always great coming out with you.
Thank you.
The cool thing about this bow is that I was shooting it. All you can reduce the poundage and you can adjust the draw length without even going to a bow shop. It's super easy. You can you don't
so
mind if she has it, do you?
Oh, that's great.
Cool.
It goes down to 5 pounds.
Cool deal. Well, you got your very own bow now, girl. So that's the end of a perfect day. Giving Lauren that bow was super special. And Lauren, I hope you have just the most fun with it. Now we're back at the house. That's one of the tilapia that we got. We threw them right on ice. And now I'm gonna fillet them up. If you've never cleaned a tilapia or if you've never touched a tilapia, they're much more rigid. Like their spines are extremely strong. Their scales are very strong. And you need a nice, good, sharp knife. Instead of cutting down through the scales, take your knife and go in between the scales. Just cut up. Cut right down like that. Then take your knife, just like everything else. Follow that backbone. All the way back to the tail. You want to leave as little meat as possible on your fish. I always like to hold the meat up with my thumb. Come up and over the rib cage. Try not to cut through the rib cage on a tilapia. Their innards are kind of disgusting. Just like that. Now, you always see me do this. I turn the fish away from me, hold the fillet up, and then I cut right down the backside of the rib bones, just like that. Now, I've got a perfect fillet. No ribs, just meat. Take your fillet and just let your knife do the work. just cut right along it there. Good. Perfect fish. Tilapia do have a little set of pin bones right there. Pretty, pretty, pretty. Now we'll just repeat the process on this side. After you rinse off your fish, pat it dry. You want your fish to be nice and dry. Okay, so many of you have been saying, it seems like you always cook the same thing. Today, I'm going out on a complete, full-on limb. I've never done, now granted, I am using original Everglades because that's like my go-to seasoning. So I'm gonna take a pan, just a little glass pan. Lay one fillet right there. And then I'm gonna take some scallions like that, put them in the middle. Then I'll take some ginger. That's ginger that I've already peeled. And I'm gonna shred it right on top. Nice. Take my other fillet and I'll make it opposite. So as if that's the way the fish was sitting. To finish it off, soy sauce. Nice. And we're just gonna let it sit in that. Give it about 15, 20 minutes just to absorb some of the flavor. So if this works, I'll go out and get a better steamer. But I just went to Walmart and I got a steamer, it was like 30 bucks. Put it together, turn it on high. Basically what you do is you put water in here and this top goes on and then this is your steaming tray. I'll wait till the steam starts rolling really nicely, and then we're gonna put the fish in. Look at that, look how nice that is. Now, I've never done this, so I'm gonna try not to burn myself. That's a lot of steam. Cover the lid. And it says I should let it steam for 12 minutes. Which means while that steams, I'm gonna start making my top. We'll take a little bit of sesame oil, just like that. In here we've got ginger, onion, a medley of mushrooms, green peppers, and orange peppers. Smell that. Can't help but to season it up with some Everglades Original. Take a little soy sauce. I wish you could smell it. It smells so good. All right, so I've got 1 cup of chicken stock in here. And I've got 1 cup of tri-colored quinoa, or couscous. I just cooked this in the last video, but I really like couscous, and it's super fast. Once you get your chicken stock boiling, throw your couscous in there. Stir it around, and then shut it off. Takes about 4 minutes, and that's just gonna come to life. There's a nice plate of couscous. Take the lid off of that. And again, I've never done this before, so it's kind of trial and error. Hopefully we don't have a massive problem. I'm gonna use 2 tongs. Whew. Slide that over there. Take our fish, just sort of offset them a little bit. We have an entire meal for a family of 4. You've got your bottom food group, your middle food group, and your top food group. Dig in, it's great. The fish with that ginger is off the chart. That is delicious. Well, this was just miraculous. I actually cooked this whole meal as a challenge to myself, but also to show you guys that I'm listening to you. I'm gonna start trying to cook all new types of food. I'm gonna try to do sushi dishes and Asian dishes and Latin dishes and Greek dishes, and because I've been cooking kind of the same food for me and my family and friends for years. And I think it's time to start branching out and trying new stuff, because we have subscribers in 260 countries. That means people from all over the world watch Deer Meat for Dinner. I want to do stuff that everyone can relate with and everyone can kind of connect with. So I appreciate all of you. This was amazing. And I want to give a very special shout out to Lauren and Matt Shramko. You two are awesome. And your sincerity and your kindness, Lauren, is amazing. I think you're just one of the most special young ladies I've ever met. So to everyone else out there in Deer Meat for Dinner land, I love you all. Take care, God bless. And we're gone.